Welcome back to the Ed Recovery Blog YouTube channel. Today we're going to be talking about the 10 things not to say to anyone that is in recovery from an eating disorder. This can be really helpful to show to friends and family or to someone that's helping in your recovery if they might not fully understand eating disorders, and it might allow them to understand a little bit better. So the first one is, I wish I could lose weight like that. So because of the way our society is, unfortunately, weight loss is something that people often compliment or seem as an achievement, when we know that that is not the case, that especially for someone with an eating disorder, this is a very difficult psychological disorder that is so much more than just losing weight, gaining weight, or the way that you eat or exercise. So this is our first one because it really shouldn't be something that is complimented, because that often lets the person who is suffering from an eating disorder think that they are doing something good and they're not doing something harmful, when in actuality, the eating disorder is extremely harmful. The second thing not to say is, why can't you just eat? So this definitely is logical, and for someone that doesn't understand eating disorders, it completely makes sense because most people are able to just eat. But for someone struggling with an eating disorder, this can really minimize their experience and make them feel like they are being overdramatic, or they're over-exaggerating, or that they don't really need help, when in actuality, they really do need that help. Our third one is, you don't look sick. So this definitely is another stigma that comes along with eating disorders, and it's the idea that just because you look a certain way that you have an eating disorder. So for example, there could be someone that's naturally pretty thin and they could not have an eating disorder, or there could be someone that is considered a normal weight and they could have an eating disorder. So it's very harmful to make comments like this, because people with eating disorders often already feel like they don't deserve the help that they need. And so saying something such as, oh, you don't really look that sick, you must not really need help, can be very harmful for their recovery. The fourth one is asking how someone lost weight. So for obvious reasons, this could be harmful for someone that's going through eating disorder recovery, because again, it's kind of complimenting the weight loss. And it also could be very triggering because you're basically asking them how they lost weight, and they know in their head that this was in an unhealthy way. And so it's definitely something that should not be said to someone that you know is struggling with an eating disorder, or just in general to anyone, but that is definitely an important one. Our fifth one is, you need to just cheer up. So a lot of times people with eating disorders also struggle with depression, anxiety, or other things like that. And a lot of times you feel hopeless in your recovery, or you're having less hope because recovery is really difficult and it often feels like things are not going to get better, even though they do. This is something definitely to stay away from saying to people, because it really just, again, minimizes their struggle. And for people that struggle with eating disorders or also depression, they can't just cheer up. There's a chemical imbalance in their brain, and that's not something that they can physically do, so it makes them feel worse because they're not able to do that. Our sixth one is, I wish I had that problem. So again, something that is in our society that we've mentioned before a few times is that weight loss is often complimented and praised, and it really should not be that way. Saying that to someone that struggles with an eating disorder, that you wish that you had their problem, first of all, minimizes the eating disorder in general, but also minimizes a lot of their pain, because someone who's going through an eating disorder and struggling to try to recover, they know that this is such a hard thing to be going through. But if someone says something like that, it makes it seem like it's not that bad. And that can definitely be difficult for someone to hear that's going through it. Our seventh thing not to say to someone that's going through eating disorder recovery is, it's all in your head. So this is a stigma for all mental illness, but saying it's all in your head kind of makes the person feel like they're crazy, or they're alone and they're the only person that's ever gone through this, which isn't the case. And so it's really important not to say this to really anyone that's struggling with mental illness, because yes, a lot of the disorders and different mental illnesses, a lot of it is because of the chemical imbalance in your brain. that doesn't mean that it's something that they're making up or that they're crazy or that there's no hope for their recovery. It just means that there's a chemical imbalance in their mind. Our eighth thing not to say to someone is, have you heard about this diet? So this could go for, you know, diets, any kind of supplements, any kind of rigid exercise routines. It's just not very helpful to tell someone who is going through eating disorder recovery about all of those things. It can be triggering to someone. It can also make them think that their behaviors that are often disordered are normalized, which they really should not be. But it can be very harmful to say this to someone because then they think, oh, well, if this person is doing it, then I guess it's not really that bad, or I guess I don't really need help, or I don't really need to change what I'm doing because someone else validated what I was doing in my eating disorder. Our ninth thing is, I wish I had your willpower. So we know that eating disorders are not about willpower. They are disorders that really just take over your entire life and mind. And again, comparing it to willpower or someone that is trying to stick to a certain diet or something is very harmful for someone because it's not about willpower, it's about something much bigger that's going on beneath the eating disorder, and the eating disorder is really just the front for what's going on, but there's much more serious things that are happening. So again, like we've said a few other times, it diminishes the person's struggle that's going through the eating disorder because it is not about willpower, it is about something much more difficult. And this can also make the person going through the eating disorder recovery feel like they are doing something that isn't that bad or even good. And that can be very harmful as well because it can just, you know, it can mess with their mind and say, okay, well, I really don't need to be in recovery, I don't need to be getting help because people are saying this is a good thing. And the 10th one, this again could be kind of applied to all mental illness. You're just doing this for attention. It can be a really harmful thing to say to anyone that is going through any kind of mental illness recovery because a lot of times people that are struggling with these illnesses think that they already are a burden and think that they are already being difficult for their family and friends. And telling them that they're doing it for attention is just gonna make that thought process so much stronger to them when it really is not the case. People with mental illnesses are not doing it for attention. It's a very, very difficult thing to be going through. No one would willingly go through it for that reason. It really just is it's a harmful thing to say to someone that is struggling because it makes them just feel worse and to feel like, again, that they're making it all up and that their symptoms aren't real. And really, it's important for them to feel very validated and to understand that there are other people that go through this, that it's not their fault, and that there really is a chemical imbalance in your brain, and it's not something that you're doing wrong. It's not because you can't think your way out of these disorders. So those are 10 things that you should not say to someone who is in recovery from an eating disorder. We hope that these helped you or help you explain to someone else that might be supporting you what things are helpful and what things are not helpful to say to someone. We also wanted to remind you guys that we are still selling our More Self-Love hoodies. We also have them in a few other designs. I'll show them up here, in a short sleeve shirt, a long sleeve shirt, and also now in a mug. And so definitely check those out. We'll have that linked below. And please also give us some ideas for videos that you want to see in the future. We really want to make sure that our YouTube channel and just our blog in general is helping you guys in all the ways that you need it. We know there's a lot of topics that could be talked about, so definitely comment them below, or you can DM us on Instagram and let us know what those things are that you're struggling with that you'd like to hear about. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time. Bye!